Hey guys, it's Tyler here from Tommy Rock. Today we're talking about the ARI Amira kit. So the kit itself all comes inside this ARI 1510 Pelican hard travel case, and it includes the ARI Amira camera body with a shoulder mount already attached to the base as well. Now, it does already have a cable to connect the viewfinder. That does come with a spare inside the case as well. It has a shotgun microphone mount. The viewfinder. Has two of these rosette handle grips. Comes with its own rods and a couple of screwdrivers as well. One thing to know about the ARI Amira is that it won't work without the viewfinder attached, because that's also the screen to operate the camera settings from. To attach that one, you flick the latch up into the unlocked position, slide it on, and lock it in place. There's a little screw at the back here that you can loosen off to rotate the angle of the viewfinder. And as well, this screw at the front allows you to rotate and as well as extend that arm out. Once you've attached that viewfinder, there's a little screw on the inside here that you can undo just with your fingers. Take that cover off, and then this cable just slots up inside there. Once that cable is in, place the cover back on and tighten that one up again with your fingers. When attaching the rods, there's just the one screw on the side here for both rods. So once that's loosened off, you can place them both in. Tighten them back up with that screw on the right hand side. Now these cameras do have a lens lock as well. So when placing a lens on or even removing the lens cap from the camera, this lock has to be unlocked first. So to unlock that, you rotate it to the left and then you can push in the button and take the lens cap off as per normal. Same with placing on a lens. Put it on as per normal, but then that lens lock just has to be locked back in place. These cameras just take V-mount batteries as well. So if you are wishing to attach the microphone mount, there's some little holes that it lines up with on the top of the camera there. And then in order to tighten that in place, you take the largest screwdriver that comes in the kit and you actually thread it through the handle hole up the top here, all the way through to the screw beneath, and tighten it from there. The camera has built-in ND filters. It has three XLR inputs on the opposite side, and it takes CFast 2.0 cards as well. The Amira has 14 plus stops of dynamic range. The license that comes in the camera has up to 100 frames per second with options of upgrading to 200 frames per second. It comes with ProRes codecs with the option of upgrading to ProRes HQ and ProRes 444. and it also records in 2K with the option of upgrading to 4K. The license that comes in the camera is this little USB stick down here, so it's important to not remove that from the camera, otherwise the camera will not be able to function. Alrighty, let's pack it all back down in its case. So same when removing the lens, take that lens lock off first. And same again when popping that lens cap back on, just making sure that lens lock goes back on. Single screw down this side. Take the rods back out. Pop the screwdriver back through the top handle to undo that microphone shotgun mount. Pop the battery back off. Undo that little thumb screw to remove that cable again. And then popping that cover back on. Pull this lever back up to release the viewfinder and slot that off. And when popping that one back in the case, just pop the little cloth back over the top to protect it. Pop these grips back in the side here, as well as the screwdriver. Make sure this bracket is nice and tucked away. And then we can pop the body of the camera back in the same way it came out. The Aria Mirror Kit is available for hire through our website at tommyrock.com.